Today topic is FortiGate authentication with Active Directory. How we can integrate FortiGate firewall with Active Directory. Active Directory we know, LDAP, Active Directory, all of these. In every organization you will find this integration. This is a common method. Not only in FortiGate but in other firewall as well. You have to integrate Active Directory to your firewall so that they can get the user detail, because we say this is a next generation firewall. So next generation firewall do policy based on user, which we call them user ID. So definitely, if you want to achieve user ID, which is the next generation firewall, one best feature, so we have to integrate with them. We already done the local user. If you remember, we create one local user and then we authenticate them. But this time we want to do through Active Directory, centralized location. Firewall will send the detail to Active Directory. They will authenticate the user. Two different method we can use, which we will discuss. So this is called Active Directory authentication. Two method we can use to integrate FortiGate firewall with Active Directory. One is active authentication. Active authentication means the user will be prompted to put the username and password credential, like this one. Whenever they plug the system to your organization LAN and they try to access any services, they will prompt them like this, that please input your detail. You can change the prompt, your logo, your detail. But anyway, there is not a difficult task. The task is nobody has to be allowed without user authentication. They will ask them, put your username and password. If they put the username and password and click continue button, then they can access the resources. In our case, we will access internet, but there can be any resources, DMZ resources, server, whatever. For active authentication, we can use LDAP, RDS, local, and TechX Plus. We already done local one. They ask them the username and password, you remember? This time we will do LDAP. And the same method can be applied to use RDS as well, and TechX Plus. These are also two more method. One is the Cisco one and the other one is the open standard RDS. And this is called active authentication. Why? It is active, it will prompt you every time. Another method is passive authentication. They will never ask you to put username and password, neither they will prompt you to put the username and password. But whenever your system is already integrated to Active Directory, like a normal organization, same as mine one, in every organization your PC is joining domain, like this one, they already joined the domain, every PC. So active authentication is basically for those which is not joining the domain. But if your all PC and system is already joined the domain organization Active Directory, then they don't need, whenever you plug them, they will take your login detail, the window login detail, and they will allow you. They will send the same window login detail to the system, to Active Directory. The firewall will send them and they will ask them to check, is this guy is the correct one? They will say yes, because this PC is under domain and they are using the same credential, it's okay. So this is called passive authentication, and mostly you will see this type of authentication in real world. This type of authentication we call them Fortinet Single Sign-On, FSSO, Fortinet Single Sign-On. means you have to one time login and you will be login forever. But for active authentication, every time you have to re-login. Okay, two method is done. This is Active Directory integration. We will use such type of topology. We will create our own. We have Active Directory. We will use Windows. You can use Windows Server 2003, Windows Server 2008, Server 2012, Server 2016, and Server 2019. It's up to you which one you want to use for Active Directory. Either you can use Linux LDAP as well. And then we need for test purpose few users. So we will use Windows XP or their Windows 10. It's up to you. Windows XP, Windows 8, Windows 10. So we will create two zones. One is DMZ zone where we will put two users. And we will create one LAN zone. And the LAN we will put the Active Directory as well. Normally you will see Active Directory in separate zone, maybe in DMZ. But we are just testing. It can be put here, either here, it's same thing. Either you can put them in separately, like inside. Normally it's in inside Active Directory. So LAN is nothing but inside. So inside we will use subnet 1 and outside, in DMZ we will use subnet 2. And then the first port which we will use for management as well and also for internet purpose as well. So this interface will work for two things for us in the lab. So this is our topology which we will use. We will enable DHCP to get all these system DHCP, all the detail automatically, because we already done DHCP, so why not utilize them? But Active Directory, we will assign them static IP. As you know, these server normally we assign them static IP. This is our topology. So initial configuration we will do, we will assign interface IP 1.100, this side 2.100, this side whatever our WAN range is, we will assign 100.100, and this we will enable DHCP here, we will enable DHCP here, and we will take two system and switch to attach them. This is the simple topology to create. And then we will configure one Active Directory. A lot of stuff to do. By the way, in real world, you don't need to configure Active Directory. This is system side job. But in this lab, we will do configure Active Directory as well. So let's do and do the basic configuration of this lab. So here I'm in Eve. You can use GNS3. You can use PNetLab, you can use cloud, and you can use Eve. It's up to you which simulation you want to use. End of the day, almost the configuration is similar. So I need one Windows server. Okay, so let me type Windows server. I just put only one server. By the way, I have other images for 16 and 19 as well. If you need, I can share. But anyway, I'm using Windows Server 2000 R2, and here I will choose RDP. RDP is better to use. VNC is also okay, and this is my server. Okay, and so this is my AD. If you want to change the name, so it's better, let me put them AD. This is the Active Directory. Now we need for test purpose few system. So let me go to Windows, and what we have, Windows 7 we have. So let me take 3 Windows 7 and put them as a RDP. Okay, so this is Windows. Okay, this two should be come here, and one has to be in LAN. Okay, so this is done. Now I need two switches to connect these. So let me go to IOL, and from here let's take this one. I need two switches. Let me give them SW and change the icon to switch. okay, and no need to do anything more. Okay, they create only one. Let me put another one as well. And another switch, and change the icon to switch layer 2, either layer 3, it's up to you. So this is inside switch, and let me select and make them here, so more space. Now I need one firewall, so let me take firewall FortiGate here. They give them the name, so we have so many firewall anyway. Let's take any of this version, it's all of them similar, and no need to do anything. So this is a firewall. Now I need internet cloud, so choose network and let me type internet. In my case, in your case, most probably you will use management for internet, but in my case is cloud one. So this is our internet and also for management as well. Now let's do basic connectivity. So this is connected to any port, we don't care which port has to be connected. It's not, and also connect this window and this one. And let me connect first port, which is DHCP enable port 1, which is a management port as well. And now connect port 2 here inside LAN, and this port go to DMZ. So my topology is ready now. Okay, there is a way to make them it's now okay. Okay, at least it's in line. Okay, let me on, and till it's on, what we will do, only one is enough right now. Till that time, let me put some text. So 192.168.1.024, and let me change the color because we are waiting so the firewall can boot and other stuff. So it's better to do some thing here, this side. So this is this subnet, and let me create another subnet this side and make them 2. Done. And let me duplicate this one. Active directory, we will assign static IP. It's up to you which IP you want to assign them. 192.168, suppose 10. So this is the IP address of active directory. And rest of everything, they will get IP through DHCP. Either you can make this active directory as a DHCP as well, which we done it. But in this case, we will make these interfaces. And let me type 100.100 with some other color like a blue or something. Anyway, they didn't done it, so it's okay. So this interface will IP will be 100. Same this interface and same above interface. It's up to you. Okay, and now let me make them a smaller now. Okay, this is the basic configuration. First, let's go to firewall. Can we access them? Double click and open secure CRT. And let's check the IP address. It's get the IP address or not, this is the issue as well. Because I'm using server, not my own system. So sometime last time which we get issue, but hopefully. So admin, there is no password. Enter new password 123123. control Q, show system interface ? So it's git. Luckily we get the same 100.100. Otherwise I was about to change them. So let me access the firewall. This is the same issue I believe now we are getting. Okay, no, it has to be HTTP because this is without license. So I hope so. If this one is accessible, then our issue will be easy now. Okay, so admin and 123. So this is my management as well and WAN as well. What is the WAN IP? Because I'm using the actual interface, so IP of this place is 1. Let me type them. 192.168.100.1. This is the gateway, okay? And basically this one. So let me put this the gateway. And 100.100 is management. Okay, so what to do first? Let's configure firewall first. Basic stuff. I don't need this one. Now let me close this one. So I need to configure these two interfaces, 1.100, 2.100. If you want to give them the name, so let me give them the name DMZ. This is our DMZ. Okay, and let me make them the other one inside. Okay, let me give in inside. So this is inside and this is DMZ. Either LAN, it's up to you, whatever name you want to give them. So let's do the basic configuration of this place. So begin and change the name. It's better to change the name FG, otherwise they will ask every time to change. Okay, so now let's see the interfaces. 2 is the LAN, 3 is DMZ, and 1 is WAN. First thing first, which we always do, go to network, go to interfaces. Okay, first interface. Okay, this is just give them WAN. Even though this is also management as well, this way management is on. Okay, now go to 2. So port 2 is our LAN. So let me give them LAN and allowed ping so that we can test them. And which IP we decide, 192.168.1.100 and 24 is the subnet mask. Ping is allowed, but we want to enable DHCP as well, as we decide. No need of second range because we have only one system, so this is enough. Default gateway will be the interface. DNS will be the same and no need to do anything, and that's done. So my LAN is enabled now, and also I put the IP and I enable DHCP. Port 3 is basically this one, which is DMZ. Okay, so let me give them name DMZ, and IP should be 2.100, which we decide. Ping will be allowed, and we enable DHCP on this one. No need of second range, and same DNS and same everything, and okay. So these two PC can get IP automatically through DHCP. And also this side, but we will assign static from this range, 1.10. Okay, so this is also done. Port 4, we are not using this, so leave it. So our interfaces is done. Next step, we always do DNS, configure DNS. To go out, we need one 8.8.8 DNS and second my 100.1 interface. 100.1 is my Wi-Fi router. It's done. It's also, by the way, mentioned here as well. It's okay. So I will use DNS these two. Another thing I need is static route. so that my all traffic can go. So all this traffic and this traffic has to go out on this interface. And next hop is 100.1, which is my router. So create new, and here anything I would say, give it to 100.1. This is the next hop I told you. And interface, choose WAN. Administrative distance 10, we already discussed these. So this was is also done. These are the basic requirement is done from firewall side. DHCP configure everything. If I go to XP, it has to get IP automatically, I believe. So let me go to XP and not XP but client. So I believe it will get automatically through DHCP from here. Let's see, test them one PC, then we will go. So by default name is, I think so, test and test 123 or user 123, I think so. User and test 123 is the username by default in Eve. Yeah, it's welcome, so it means it's the correct one. User and password is T capital test 123. If you want to use the same image in your Eve, by the way, it's all of them is like this. So this is my DMZ client. I just want to test that it's getting IP automatically or not. So let's go to, it should be 1 or 2 IP because 100 we assigned to the interface, and DHCP range is from 1 to 99. So this is my LAN interface. And it's get 2.1. It's correct. It get the gateway, it get the DNS and another DNS. So it means our DHCP is working. So let me minimize this one. Okay. And hopefully it will get, this PC will also get automatically. If this one is get, so it means it's correct. Now coming to the difficult part, which is out of scope, but we are doing. And that is to configure Active Directory. So click on Active Directory. Okay. And we will do remote desktop to Active Directory server 2008. Why is not going? Let me remove this PC right now. No need right now. So let me do. What else to do? It has to do it. For some reason, let me test this one. Let me refresh. Okay, yeah, it's blocked here, sorry. So allowed and done. Let me allow forever. Why is blocking this browser? Okay, now so let's see, we have, can do right now or not. Yeah, it's time. This time I open it. So now I want to go to Active Directory to make the basics configuration. Okay. By default, username is administrator, and password is test123. This one is user and test123. And this one is, let me show you, test123, in case you want to use this in your Eve. These are the default credential. I will share all the Eve username and password, whatever image you want to use. There is a list also available on internet. So now I'm in Active Directory. So let's go to and assign them static IP first. We can assign from many places, from here, control panel from here. Anyway, let's check them first here to assign this, the first step to create them. So why it's not showing me here? So it's better to go to control panel and go to network sharing center and change adapter setting. Maybe it's get automatically. Yeah, it's get 1.1 automatically. So let's give them the same 1.1 IP, by the way. Either 10, it's up to you. No need IPv6, disable this one. And 192.168.1.1. Suppose let me give them 200. And 192.168.1.100 is the gateway. You remember, here is the firewall IP. 8.8.8 is DNS, and 192.168.100.1 is another DNS. But I think so, instead of 8.8, we will use this server as a DNS as well. 192.168.1.200. And okay. So I changed my mind and I assigned them 200 IP to the server. And it's require a static IP. This is the first step. Static IP is configure. Now go to, you can click from here, either from here. So this is 1.200. Okay. By the way, there is IPv6 hasn't to be enabled. If you refresh, it will go anyway. If I close, you can click from here. Okay, so SRV is the name, 1.100, remote desktop is enabled. We don't need. Do not show this again. Now what you need to do, I just need one role before Active Directory to install. Click on add role. Okay, click next. And there is Active Directory Domain Services. This Active Directory Domain Services has to be installed before configure Active Directory and install. So until that time, let me change this IP so we are not confused. I change my mind because 10 is coming under the DHCP pool. So rather than to make some issue, is better to assign IP which is out of scope IP of DHCP. So I assign them 200. Okay, and now this service is required for Active Directory to configure Active Directory. Also, we will need DNS role. So let's wait for this one, Active Directory Domain Services. Active Directory is basically a centralized location where we create user group and so many other things, systems and all. And from there, we can authenticate to the centralized location. Mostly organization are using Microsoft, and nowadays you will see a server 2016 most of them, and maybe some organizations switch over to the server 2019 as well. But end of the day, concept are almost similar, only the the graphical will be different, like a Windows XP and 7 and 8. So there is a bit different, yeah, the same as in server. In 2019, they give them like a Windows 10 type of display. So we need this one first to, okay, let's go to do what thing. Okay, so this is my DMZ, it's get IP, and this should, they will get also an IP which we can verify from firewall as well, by the way, admin 123, which we done in DHCP. If we go to firewall, and go to monitor, and there is a DHCP monitor. They will show you the IP, and LAN they assigned one IP, and DMZ they assigned one IP. So it's true and it's correct. Okay, now let's go back to Swiss install. Okay, window automatic update is not enabled. It's okay if they have some error. Now they say if you want to launch Active Directory, either type DC promo, either click here. So why not click here is better. Otherwise you can type here DC promo. So this prompt will come. Click next. Next. We are using create new domain. This is the first time we are creating. And let me give them name test.local. Any name you can give them. Test.local. Either test.lab is up to you. Let me make them more simple. Test.lab. This is my domain name. Fully qualified domain name. Test.lab. Okay. They will check that maybe this name is already there or not. So let's see that. Okay, so what we done, we give them the name, alias name WAN interface, we configure WAN, we configure LAN interface, we enable DHCP, we configure DNS, and then we configure default route to push all the traffic there. And we enable on DMZ, DHCP server there as well, and LAN as well, okay. Now this part we will do after this Active Directory. So they say which one, so I say Windows Server 2000R2, either 2000R, it's up to you, whatever you want to choose, domain functional, okay. Now we did not install DNS, it's require a DNS by the way. Active Directory have some prerequisite. One of them server has to be static IP, second one there should be a DNS, okay. So maybe they will install automatically Active Directory, DNS is required. DNS we discuss, you remember. So yes, we say install DNS because it's required. So next, okay, and yes, they will install DNS. Either you can install DNS from add role in advance. Okay, it's up to you, but it requires, so it will do. Now they are installing. Do you want to continue? Yes. So they will store their database. This is NTDS, okay, in here. And syslog, all the policy will be stored here in this location. Now we need a complicated password. ABC@1234.5. ABC@1234.5. And confirm them. If you want to export all your detail, you can export anyway, we don't need. And we just want to install Active Directory. Okay, so they are writing all the detail, whatever we have, Active Directory and DNS configuration. After a while they will complete the configuration. Then next step, we will configure DNS, which we study by the way. Now we will see how we are configuring DNS, which is must and require for Active Directory. It has to be properly configured, and by default it's not configured. We will see how we can configure them and how we can test them, their DNS is properly working or not. So let's see, they are still working on it. It will take a bit, maybe 1 more 2 minutes. And then we will configure DNS properly. So our Active Directory will be ready. After ready this one, we will create user inside Active Directory. which is required for user authentication. So we will create some group, then we will put some user, and then we will authenticate them, those user, through PCs which we have Windows. And also we will call that group inside our policies. But before that, we will integrate our Active Directory to FortiGate firewall. These are our steps which we want to achieve. Okay, so still maybe they require a reboot as well. Sometime when you install Active Directory and do everything, so they will ask you to reboot the system. Okay, before the name was SRV, now it will be test.local. You remember? It was only showing, we go to property, so S is SRV, still it's not yet. It will show the full name here. Okay, domain is here now, but it should be server.test.local after a while. Okay, so you know when it's done, let me increase time. You know, it's always disconnected. Yeah, so let me go to system setting, session out. I need to increase the session out. This is the session out, idle timeout. Whenever I'm coming, it's idle timeout 5 minutes. So the last one is 480. So now it will be not log out again and again. Okay, let's go back. Okay, it's done and finish. Unfortunately, they say you have to restart the Active Directory to work. So restart now, and our Active Directory will be ready after rebooting this server. Okay, so we need to wait for a while. Okay, and it's better to stop them here. So our basic configuration is done up to this point. Our DHCP is working, system is getting IP, our interfaces is configured, per interface DHCP is enabled, and we have one Active Directory which we configure. But by the way, there is a DNS as well. So let me wait. I thought let me close the video, but we need to configure DNS as well. Then our everything will be ready. So let me try again if we can access them. So let me do RDP again. Because it's rebooting, so until that time it will not take RDP. We have to wait, so maybe it will disconnect, then we will try again. Because still we are not sure it's rebooted yet or not. Okay. So let me type here, the username is administrator. And password is test123. This is Active Directory one. Server 2, any server which you are using. So this is the username, okay? And the system username and password is, okay, let me change this one to user. User. This is the default username and password. So it's not working because the system was not on, so my session was disconnected. Let me do it again. and hopefully this time it will be okay. So it's come up administrator, not this one, use different, not the hukum, I think. So our one is administrator at the rate test dot lab, and password is test 123. Okay, so it's showing us that they're going to apply all the setting which we configure Active Directory. It will take some time to apply the policy, then we will configure DNS. Okay, now they say change the password. It requires. So what was the old password? Test 123. And let me ABC at the rate 12345. And change it. Does not match. Sorry. Password is, there is test 123. New password is ABC at the rate 12345. And repeat ABC at the rate 12345, and now change it. So password is changed, now we can log in. The last thing which we need here to configure DNS and to create some users. Okay, so it's come up now. Click on this one. Okay. So it's come up. We have some role installed now. Okay, but if we go to role and click on DNS, either you can go from here as well. Okay, from it will show here as well, administrative tools, and there should be DNS. When you click on DNS, either from here, it's bring me here. So this SRV is my system name. Forwarding lookup, you know, I told you in DNS. So test.local SRV and 1.20 is there, but reverse lookup zone is not there, so it's not configured. How I know? If you click on SRV and click launch NS lookup, there will be error. This the error. We need to remove this error. Then DNS will be configured. This is the shortcut way. So first thing first, our forwarding lookup is there. DNS is translating domain name to IP and IP to domain. Remember? Right click, reverse lookup zone, next primary zone, next IPv4. So what is our network ID? 192.168.1. Next and finish. So my reverse lookup zone is there, but again there will be an error. If I click launch NS lookup, still there is some error. Why? I don't have entry for the reverse. So create pointer. And 200 is the SRV server. Click on SRV forwarding test server and OK. And now let's try again for the last time. OK. So it's still giving me error. Why? I told you we need to disable IPv6. So let's go to it creating issue. Go to control panel. Go to network and sharing center, change adapter setting. So I think I remove from this, but not from the other one. So IPv6 is disabled here. So maybe this one is creating issue. There is another one, disable this one. By default, this is IPv6 is powerful. It get that one. So So now let's go to our DNS. Okay. Okay, just stuck for a while, so let's see. Control Alt Delete. Stuck. Okay, so we are back now. Let me cancel and let's go to DNS again. Administrative tool, go to DNS and let's see same error either because we disable IPv6 now. And click on server, right click, launch NS lookup. So now it's okay. Default server is SRV test.lab and this is our domain. And if you type SRV, it will show you the IP. And if you type IP 1.200, it will show you the host name. This what we do, yeah, this DNS do. Because in DNS we have only one entry. We don't have any user. Otherwise, if you type PC1, it will give you PC1 IP. But we don't have anyway. My DNS is okay. And how you can verify? Right click, launch NS lookup. It will show you server name and IP, that's it. So forwarding lookup zone was already there. I create reverse lookup zone and I put the entry PTR, which we discuss. Now DNS is ready. The last thing before this basic setup is to create an user in Active Directory. So go to Active Directory. There is Active Directory user in computer. We will need some test user. So this is test.lab is my domain. There is user. Why not create a separate OU? Create new organization unit. We call them OU and call them suppose firewall. So I create a separate OU for my own lab purpose. And here I need to create user now. So create user, suppose user one. Either suppose we have IT and cell, okay, either HR1 is the username and it require a complicated password. So let me remove complicated password setting. So if I go to administrative tool, there is one group policy management so that I can give them simple password. Otherwise I will need a complicated password to set. So group policy, group policy, next. No, there is one way. Administrative tool, I need to remove the where is group policy? I think so it's group policy management. This one, yes, this should be here. It's not, I cannot create. Maybe I'm in the wrong place. Yeah, domain, sorry. Yeah, domain test. And there is a default group policy. Okay. And let me edit. I just want to put simple username and password. So for that purpose, I am here to create a user base, I think so. Either the system base. I can't remember, it's been ages I use them. But anyway, let me come to administrative. And there is some security. I think so in Windows, yeah, I remember something. Okay, so let me go to window. Okay. And there is security. And security, there is local policy. And account policy, this is the password policy. They say at least has to be 7 characters. So I say leave it 7 characters. 1 character. And they say it should be complicated password. I say disable complicated password. And that's it. Okay, but for this one, if it is to work, I need to apply the policy. So there is a command gpupdate/4 something. I hope it will work. Let's see now. I want to create some user. So user, let me create HR1. Username is HR1. Next, I want to put 123. User cannot change password and password never expire. And finish. So HR1 is created. Let me make a copy of this one. Sorry, I disable them. Enable account. There is to copy. Yeah, copy. And HR2. Next. 123. And 123. And finish. 2 user is enough. And let me create 2 more user in another one. Another. Maybe IT1. Either cell 1, SAL cell 1, 123 and 123. User cannot change the password, password never expire, and okay. And let me copy them. SAL 2. Next 123, and finish. Now I need to create 2 group to put them. This is the beauty of Active Directory, so that we can apply the rule group base. So one group is HR. Okay, next. And another group is, let me go back to new. And where is group? Here, cell, and okay. Now go to HR group. You know the. Let me make them bigger. From where we can make them, there is an option. I forgot there is something to show. Yeah, this one. Something was to show bigger. You know this two. This is group, and this is one person is looking. This is user. Okay. So in HR, no one is there. So let me add those 2 user here. So member, I will say add HR1, check name and add, apply, and HR2, check name and okay. So 2 user is been added. Either you can say cell and add to group. Which group? Cell group, check name and okay. And now cell, right click, add to group, cell, check name and okay. So if I come to cell, there 2 user will be already there. Yeah, cell 1, cell 2. Okay, and if I go to HR1, so 2 member are there, HR1 and HR2. That's it. This is the test purpose we need to create, and our Active Directory is now ready. Everything is done and the basic configuration is done. Now we will move to our main topic. So let me stop this.